The transposable elements we're interested in are old retroviruses that infected genomes millions of years ago, sometimes decades ago, and they are directly related to HIV. We're really interested in how RNA can recognize a good or bad retrovirus or transposon. Basically, half of our DNA are these transposable elements and old retroviruses. And they can be bad if they're active and they like move around, but they can actually be also very good. So hosts have adopted genes from retroviruses and they're essential. It's a bit like DNA Lego, and like the pieces are able to move around, but then at some point you have really essential infrastructure and you can't just like take them away. So we're now in this place where we need them, but we need to make sure that we can sense and control and manage them. The retroviruses that we study, they use transfer RNAs, an essential RNA component in the cell, to replicate. It's a very interesting example of small RNAs because we think they're probably quite ancient. We can only speculate when it comes to evolution, but the tRNA certainly were one of the first molecules to enable life. So we're very interested in how these tRNA fragments recognize and regulate retroviruses. And we want to learn more about the mechanism. They are a relatively novel small RNA class. They clearly overlap with other RNA silencing pathways. RNA silencing is like kind of like a primitive immune system, and we can think of this very much in evolutionary terms. Why did it evolve? How did it evolve? How does it manage to sort out which transposons are okay and which are not okay? One of the applications, of course, also is to learn how to maybe prevent retrovirus infection or how to manage it. There are still a lot of retroviruses out there, so this will be very useful. And then the other thing to know is that a lot of cancer cell types and tumors have very, very high transposon expression. And so if we could use these molecules that we study to basically control them and inhibit them, we could have a handle on cancer, improve cancer care or outcomes.